Hey, welcome. And I just wanted to just send a few words out, and just man, my heart goes just seriously. My heart is just heavy for the victims of the Joplin, Missouri, that tornado that happened down there. And by most estimates, it's the worst natural disaster tornado-wise in U.S. history, as far as cost of loss of life. And man, my heart is just so heavy for those people down there in Joplin, Missouri. And I also just wanted to just take a few minutes to just inform and educate y'all about the reason for such things, and not so much tornadoes, but about the timing of the tornadoes and certainly the seriousness of natural disasters as God's word is concerned. And throughout, since Israel was again a nation after 1800 plus years, God brought them back to the land in 1948. And the Bible asks a very, very, I think, relative question in Isaiah, I believe the 66th chapter in the 8th verse. And God was talking about, but before that time, he's talking about how Israel, but he was going to disperse Israel throughout the whole world because they were disobedient to him, and they rejected him and chased after other gods. And he asked a question, and he said that in this Isaiah. So he said that, he said, who has heard such a thing, saw a nation be born in one day? And we know the UN voted Israel in as a nation in 1948, right after the Civil War, right after World War II. And what was interesting is that before that scripture, also it talks about how Zion or Israel travailed, in that right before there was travail and there was pain. And we know that when there is pain with birth, the most pain comes right before the child comes through into the world. And that the greatest pain in Israel's history was in the death camps in Nazi Germany. By some estimates, 6 million Jews were killed. Now, there was 11 million people killed, so there was 5 million other non-Jews, so we don't want to certainly marginalize those folks. But that the pain, the no pain in their history as a people equaled that of the 6 million killed. And the Bible says that Zion travailed and then brought forth her children. So the biggest disaster, just human toll in death in Israel's history happened in Nazi Germany from around 1938, 1939, all the way up through 1945, 6 million Jews killed. And then a few years later, Zion brought forth her children, or Israel was declared a land in one day, just like the scripture has said it was. And what we all know is that President Obama, like his predecessors, George W. Bush, before him Bill Clinton, before him George H.W. Bush, going all the way back to President Johnson, they have tried to twist Israel's arm to give up land for peace. The first thing that you have to understand is that this thing between Arabs and Jews has been going on since the time of Ishmael, which was Abraham's firstborn son, and Isaac, to whom the covenant was promised, who was the father or Abraham's son, and Abraham was father of the Hebrews or the Jews. And this thing has been going on since, what is that, 3,000, about 35, 36, 3,700 years. No peace is going to happen between Arabs and Jews. No other country on the face of the earth is surrounded by other nations and have the ability to make more war that want to kill them. They're surrounded on the west by Palestinians who, you know, Hamas wants to wipe them out. They're surrounded in the north. They're surrounded in the south. And they're surrounded in the east. They are surrounded by people who want to wipe them out. So President Obama brings in Benjamin Netanyahu and tells him to go back to the pre-1967 borders. This is, and I'm leading somewhere with this, and this has to do with the tornado in Joplin. He tells him to go to the pre-1967 borders. Brief history lesson. Arabs attacked Jews unprovoked in 1967 and 1973. So three times they attacked Jews, and we know in the 1973 war was called the Yom Kippur War. They had just gotten back in the land in 1948, and in 1967, for the first time in over 1900 years, the Jews controlled their ancestral holy city, which is Jerusalem. And this is just how this is what happened. So for them to go back to the pre-1967 borders would essentially mean they would be giving up all the entire, what's called the West Bank. It's called Judea and Samaria. That's what it's called. But people won't call it the West Bank, whatever. So understand this. Those borders, if they went back to those borders, not only would they not be in control of Jerusalem, their eternal holy capital, they would not be able to defend themselves, and they would their land become smaller. So this was the political play. President Obama asked Israel to do something he knew Israel was not going to do, which is go back to the 1967 borders and give up Jerusalem. And they're talking about East Jerusalem and West Jerusalem and all of these other things. The second thing is the president knew that his own party, nor the Republican Party, would ever go for something like that. He knew that, but the political play was that the president just wiped out Osama bin Laden, which gave him huge political capital over a lot of the world. So he doesn't want Arabs thinking that he, by killing bin Laden, he's in war against Arabs or against Islam. So he uses his political capital gained by the killing of Osama bin Laden to come out and tell Israel, whom he knew Israel wouldn't go back to those 1967 borders. He knew the American people wouldn't go for that through Congress. So he uses that to demand something he knew was not going to happen. He wanted Arabs to see that he was tough on the Jews as he's tough on the war on terror. That's all this was. It was just a political calculation. People, let me give you a brief history. There was a movie starring George Clooney in the early 90s called The Perfect Storm. And The Perfect Storm was actually based on real life events. They were. So President George H.W. Bush, who's President Bush's father, he was opening at the time he was opening the Madrid conference in the so-called land for peace. And right when he started doing that, the perfect storm develops over the Atlantic, which produced the largest waves ever recorded in the Atlantic Ocean on the East Coast. And what's really interesting is that Bush tried to divide God's land. And guess what? His home in Kennebunkport, Maine was destroyed. Next thing, Hurricane Andrew, August 23rd, 1992, when the Madrid conference moved to Washington less than a year later, this so-called land for peace between Palestinian and Jews resumed. Hurricane Andrew was the worst natural disaster ever to hit America, and it came ashore and it produced $30 billion worth of damage. Right, and it formed when they regathered this Madrid peace conference. Next thing was the Monica Lewinsky scandal. We remember that Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu was prime minister also at that time. He met with President Clinton at the White House, and he was coldly received. And Clinton and Secretary Madeleine Albright refused to have lunch with him. A few weeks later, Bill Clinton is busted out. His secrets are all over, just all over the news. Richard Nixon in 1973, he knew that this Arab coalition was going to attack Israel in what was called the Yom Kippur Wars. Now, we know that the Watergate break-in happened in 1972, but did you notice that right after that, less than a few months after, he refused to tell the Jews that they were going to be attacked in the land that God gave them, this whole thing busts, this whole thing breaks open. This whole Watergate scandal, God exposed him just like he exposed Bill Clinton. And later on, we know that articles of impeachment came up against Bill Clinton and Richard Nixon a little over a year later, after he refused to tell the Jews he had to resign the presidency. Shall I go on? Let's talk about Hurricane Katrina. 1 week before Katrina made landfall, there was these talks that had been going on for some months to drag Jews from Judea and Samaria, called the West Bank, from their home and on the land that God gave them. And they we remember the images on TV of Israeli soldiers dragging Jews out of their homes in the land God gave them, kicking and screaming. And this was a scheme by Bush and Condoleezza Rice to try to befriend these Palestinians and these Arabs, who all they do is want to destroy the Jews. There's going to be no peace until the Jews are driven into the sea. Read the charter of the Palestinian Liberation Organization. Read the literature of Hamas. They don't want peace. They want to drive the Jews in the sea, but I digress. So Hurricane Katrina, and we know that wiped out all, that just changed the face of New Orleans. And they were dragging Jews off the land right when that happened. Do we need to also talk about the powerful super tornado, May 3rd, 1999? And that was on the same day that Yasser Arafat declared a Palestinian state. And and with Jerusalem at his capital, when people are pressuring the Jews to give up land. So all I'm saying, people, is since Israel has become a nation, the worst natural disasters, and now we have Joplin at the very time that President Obama is telling Benjamin Netanyahu to give up the land. God is not playing, people, about his land. And how do you biblically, what does that have to do with the Bible? At the book of Zechariah in the 12th chapter tells us, and it shall happen in that day that all that Jerusalem shall be a heavy stone, and all who burn themselves with it will surely be cut into pieces. And people are trying to divide the eternal capital. There is no other city on earth since the beginning of time that God said, this is my city. Now, we know that the Bible says the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof and they that dwell therein. But that no God claimed that particular plot of land as his own. And he told Abraham in the 12th chapter, in the third verse of the book of Genesis, that I will bless them that bless thee and curse them that curseth thee. And through you, the whole world will be blessed. And by trying to rip away that covenant that God made with Abraham from the physical descendants of Abraham, the U.S. presidents are playing and thumbing their nose at the God of heaven whom they say they believe in. Also, in Joel, in the third chapter, it says, I will gather all nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat. There I will enter into judgment against them concerning my inheritance for my people Israel, for they scattered my people among the nations and gathered and parceled up my land. God is not playing about his land. Joplin is just the latest example of this. And as a preacher of the gospel, I demand this of the U.S. government. If you want Israel to give back the land that God had for them, why don't you give back? Why don't you take back that a saying that brought the early colonial Americans spread west called manifest destiny? Why don't you give back Texas to the Mexicans because that was their land? Why don't you give Utah back to the Mexicans because that was their land? Why don't you give back Arizona to the Mexicans? Mexicans because that was their land. And why don't you give back California to the Mexicans and that was their land, and you are, and now you're running them out of America, calling them these illegal immigrants. You dragging them off their land. You won't even give up your land. And you want this land there, and God didn't promise you America. You took America. So, and you want these people that God, the Bible that you put and swear your hand on, Congress opens up their sessions with prayer, and you say, God bless, may God bless America, and may God bless the United States people. Listen, that same God that you say you pray to is serious about his land. Israel surrounded by enemies. You're not even surrounded by enemies, and you won't give up more land so you can tighten. So, and these people, all they want to do is tighten the noose around the neck of these Jews. Nobody wants them. We know when Hitler was doing his thing back in World War II, America turned a ship full of desperate Jews away and sent them back to Nazi Germany, and those people ended up dead. So nobody wants these people. They are hissing, and God said this. Now, I'm not trying to be an Israeli apologist because they're in the position they're in because they were disobedient to God, and God said that these things would be so. So we have to understand how serious God is about his land, people. The Bible says that. And why don't you give the Indians back their land and shut down those POW camps that you call reservations? Why don't you give the Japanese Americans back their property that you hijacked from them, their plots of land that you hijacked from them when you put them in those concentration camps in World War II for being nothing other than Japanese, for being Japanese? And see, this is the thing. This is the hypocrisy that goes on here. And as I close here, I am begging all of you who see this to understand that God is serious about his land. If this, you know, NSA, FBI, CIA, whoever you is, pass this to the president. Mr. President, listen, man, I know that, you know, you believe that there's these political games that you have to play in order to be a great president. But you have to understand, you twist the arm. If you twist the arm of any Israeli leader, man, every time you do that, I guarantee you Americans are going to suffer, and a few of them are going to pay with their lives like they did in Joplin, Missouri, like they did during Hurricane Andrew, like they did through Hurricane Katrina, the Northridge earthquakes, Hurricane George, that powerful super tornado. And Mr. President, you need to be a real friend, man, to Israel, and stop trying to play games with them, man. God is not playing about his land. Whatever you got going on, man, God will expose it like he did Bill Clinton, like he did Richard Nixon. You think it's a coincidence that Lyndon Johnson didn't do anything to really help the Jews in the 1967 war, 1968? He says, "I will not see, nor will I accept the Democratic nomination to be your president." Less than a year later, you think that was a coincidence? Mr. President, stand with those people, man. You don't need to please anybody but the Lord God of heaven, the one you say you pray to. So be it.